Hi everyone, thank you, welcome you all for my poster presentation here. So I am Nesrin Ali from Finland. I am presenting Aalto University from Finland, and I am going to share these very interesting results, our recent results concerning glucose sensing in the skin. Basically, the main of this project is to find out a potential biomarker, gene or protein, which can be responding specifically to glucose in healthy and type 1 diabetic mouse model, basically. And further, this biomarker will be used for developing what we call non-invasive devices to sense glucose level in type 1 diabetic patient. So to start, so the first question that we have asked, whether the skin sense glucose or not. So for that, we have developed a protocol where the end time point was 45 minutes after glucose injection. So a very simple experiment that we have done. I don't have, where is the laser? Anyway, so the first thing that we have done is we injected two groups of mice, healthy mice, with one group with BBS and the other group with glucose. And we have measured the glucose concentration in these four groups. As you can see, we were successful to show a significant increase in the glucose uptake in the skin biopsy collected from the healthy or type 1 diabetic mice, where they have been injected with the glucose compared to the control. This has been confirmed by the glucose GLUT1, which is a glucose well-known glucose transporter, a gene at first at the mRNA level and then at the protein level, as you can see. So what we concluded that indeed the skin sends very well glucose at 45 minutes after injection. So then we moved on and we performed proteomic analysis using mass spectrometry analysis, and our aim to find again this biomarker which can be responding really to glucose and independently of the insulin pathway. And we have been successful to find two protein out of I think it was around 1,400 protein that we screened. So one of these protein, I'm going to present you Trisc95. This Trisc95 is one of the most important protein in skeletal muscle, where it plays a major role in the calcium release from the ER to the cytosol. So we confirmed basically our data from proteomic analysis in immunofluorescence using the C2, C12, which is a very well-known muscle cell line as a positive control. And as you can see in the 5 millimolar primary keratinocyte incubated with a 25 millimolar unrelated keratinocyte, there is much more increase in these protein localized in the ER specifically. And this increase has been confirmed by Western lab, as you can see, and using again the positive and the negative control, which is heart muscle, which if this protein is not detected at all. So then we have asked the question whether the glucose can affect directly the expression of the Trisc95 at gene expression level. So we have performed a luciferase study, and we have found a significant increase in the promoter of this Trisc95 45 minutes after high glucose treatment. So indeed, this protein is very, very nice biomarker because it's responding at a gene level and the protein level. So what we have then asked ourselves, if the protein, what this protein is doing in keratinocyte, because it hasn't, it's not known at all to be expressed, or the function of this protein hasn't been at all elucidated in the in the keratin site. So we move to the function of this protein, as we refer to the skeletal muscle. So this protein is responsible of the calcium release, as I told you previously, calcium release from the ER to the cytosol. So we asked us whether this protein can also play the same role in keratinocyte and after high glucose. And indeed, whenever we incubate the cells with the high glucose, there is significant increase in the intracellular calcium 45 minutes after. This has been done in primary cells, and then we have injected the mice with the glucose. At 45 minutes, we isolate the primary cells, and we also measure the calcium, intracellular calcium, and indeed, there is significant increase in the calcium, intracellular calcium. Why? When we have done the experiments using knockout Cas95, we haven't seen any differences in the intracellular calcium between the mouse injected with high glucose and BBS. Furthermore, we have been able to, since we are touching the calcium, meaning that we should absolutely have a link to mitochondria, because mitochondria is the first organelle that have been able to uptake the calcium when it's elevated in the ER. So we checked the morphology of mitochondria, and we saw that there is indeed a fragmentation in the mitochondria in the mice injected with healthy mice injected with the glucose compared to the control. And whenever we are doing the same experiment using the Trisc95 knockout, we couldn't find any phenotype. So to conclude, this protein is like really the center of the calcium and mitochondrial function, because it's indeed regulating the calcium concentration in the intracellular, in the cytosol, cytosolic and mitochondria. And this is here I do not show, because we the conclusion what we draw that in normal in low glucose, so the Trisc95 is behaving normally, leading to the calcium to calcium released from the ER to the cytosol, while when there is a high glucose, this protein is upregulated, leading to the closure of the ryanodine channel, which is very important channel in the ER. So leading to this increase of the calcium in the ER, which detectable directly by the mitochondria, which uptake this calcium. And here where I do not show, because we have measured the uniportal calcium, mitochondrial uniportal calcium, and they are increased indeed. So showing that this relationship between ER and mitochondria, they are absolutely important in the cellular regulation. So this is the conclusion that at risk 95, where I can go back to my title, so it's at risk 95 as a normal skin level for normal and diabetes systematic glucose level, and we hope that using this protein we can be able further using the gene editing and all the help from our colleague engineer to develop miniaturized microscope to detect the Trisc95 from inside of the cells. So thank you so much, and if you have a question, please welcome.